Hello friends, today I'm going to explain to you what a work breakdown structure is. Now, when you are planning a project, you need to make a WBS, and this is specifically done after you have made your scope of work and you have defined the scope of your project. So work breakdown structure as defined by PMI, which is Project Management Institute, is a hierarchical and incremental decomposition of project into phases, deliverables and work packages. What it means is that it should be there should be a certain hierarchy. So your entire work that you're going to do, it should be based on a hierarchical structure, and there should be deliverables and sub-deliverables broken down onto a level where you get all the work packages and you have defined everything that is in your project. There are certain points to be noted. First, the 100% rule. That is, you should be able to cover all the work that you have to do in the project within this WBS. Second, levels to be mentioned in standard format. So there are certain standard format on how you make a WBS. We'll go through that. Third, it may include budget and man hours distribution. Now, in some companies, they include the budget and man hours, which gives a better idea on which work packages are more intense and how much man hours or budget needs to be allocated to them, and then it helps in the planning for later on as well. D, mutually exclusive elements. So all elements should be mutually exclusive. There should not be any ambiguity that they are overlapping with each other, and it should be outcome oriented. So that means that the level should be such that they lead to a certain outcome. How it happens, I'll explain you. So let's come here. So this is a project structure tree that I have made. It was, the main deliverable of the project is that shifting of Tata plan from Singur to Sanand. Now you can see that this is level 0, and then I have broken down it into three outcomes, which I explained earlier. So dismantle and pack at Singur, transport from Singur to Sanand, and then reassemble and commission at Sanand. So, and then what, as you can see that I've divided only this one into the further work packages. Now each of them, you can see, has a nomenclature attached to them. It's very methodical. So A is given here, then A1, 2 and 3. And from A2, all these arise. So A2, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Now one more, and this is quite methodical in the sense that there are two variables over here. So 2 minus 1. That is a level 1. Here three variables are here, minus 1, level 2. Quite simple to remember. And one more thing, you can see that for each of them, I have mentioned the man hours and the budget, which is further broken down for each of them. So this gives a better outlook and helps in planning the schedule much better. Coming down here, so the project structure tree can be made in a tabular format as well. And this would be a standard way. I've just shown it in a very small sequence here. So you can see A2, transport from Singur to Sanand, which was here, which I have transposed over here. And then the subtasks within A2 will all be listed here. Once they are complete, then we'll come to the next, which could be A1 or A3, which will be listed here. And then all the subtasks of this. You can see that the description for each of the tasks is given, which helps us in understanding what each work describes. I hope you have got a good overview of what a work breakdown structure is, and it will help you in planning a project much better now. Thank you.